big part of surgery for adolescent idiopathic scoliosis. If we schedule your AIS for a PSF, what we mean is a posterior spinal fusion. We do the surgery from behind your back. We make an incision down your back. We use x-ray or fluoroscopy, very low dose, during surgery to help us with the safety as we introduce the screws into your bone, and then the rods attached to that, we manipulate that around. Equally or more important to that is the fusion part. And by fusion, I mean we get your bone to heal solid as one piece in that area that we're operating on. So if you want to think of those metal rods that we put in to straighten your back, they sort of serve as internal structures in the wall, like a house, until the bone around that can heal solid, and then the rods aren't so important anymore because the bone's now solid. But we leave the rods in place because it would be a big operation to remove those. And rarely do we have to remove the rod. Depending on how much of your spine needs to be operated on, the surgery will take anywhere from 3 to 6 hours, as a general rule. We will update mom and dad on how the surgery's going during the course of the operation. And then when we finish everything, you as the patient are gonna then go to the recovery room, and it's gonna be another 30 or 60 minutes before mom and dad get to see you as you begin to wake up and you're made more comfortable, and make sure your pain is nicely under control. So the goal of the surgery itself is to improve the posture of your back, line it up in a straighter position, lock it in there, and leave it that way so that the rest of your life it stays in a good position. And the areas of your back that we don't operate on remain flexible, and so you still have some motion in your back. And sports such as volleyball or tennis or basketball or soccer, we want you to be able to get back to those same sports. It's gonna take some time, yeah, but I think you can plan to be released to those sports between 4 and 6 months following your operation.